A slightly less techie question I'd go for now, but we've got a question from Holly Marshall. She's asking you, why is Mad Dog called Mad Dog? So why are you called Mad Dog?
Well, it's a long story, and it's been repeated many times in the net, Holly. But I will tell you that at the age of 63, you're seeing somebody who has learned to control his temper a little bit. At the age of 27, I didn't have quite as much control of my temper. At that time, I had a dean of instruction at a university who was British, very proper, wore a suit every day, and I would come in a t-shirt and shorts. He believed the best way of teaching students was that the professor was up here, and the students were down there, and I believed the best way of teaching students was to take them out for beer and pizza after class. Now, I know there's a whole bunch of students out there, I used to have heated discussions with this dean of instruction, and sometimes the arguments were too hot for Mad Dogs and Englishmen. Right. He was British, and I was the Mad Dog. And I've learned over the years that losing your temper is not the way to win an argument, that if you control your temper, that is the best thing to do. In fact, sometimes I actually work to make other people lose their temper, and then I win the argument. So that's how I got the name, and I use that name to remind me constantly never to lose my temper. It doesn't mean I don't get angry at something. It doesn't mean I don't feel there's something to correct, but it means that I don't lose my temper.